Welcome to EPG Pathshala lecture series in computer science. This course is on operating systems, and we have been learning about memory management in the past two modules, and in today's module we'll continue with paging, details related to paging. So the learning objectives for today's class are that we learn how page tables are implemented actually, and how a translation look-aside buffer can be used along with the usual page table, and how memory protection can be provided when you have a page table. And we will also learn about different ways in which, or different structures that can be used for page tables, like the hashed page tables and inverted page tables. So what we had learnt in the earlier class is that we learnt about paging, the concepts of paging, where we understood that the logical address space of a process is divided into equal sized partitions called pages, and the physical memory is divided into equal sized partitions, the same size partitions called frames, and the pages are placed into the frames in the physical memory. And you need to remember where each page has been placed in the physical memory, and for that you need to have a data structure, and that is done using a page table. So the page table does the mapping from the pages to the frames in the physical memory. And having learnt about this paging, concept of paging, today we will see how this page table can be implemented. We saw that a page table is allocated for each process. Each process has got its own page table, and in the process control block, a pointer to this page table is stored. And because of that, what is the use? When you have a page table for each process, when that process is taken up for execution, the page table for that process has to be loaded. Say now there is a context switch, and the next process has to be given the CPU. Then in that case, the page table of the newly coming process has to be loaded. So there needs to be a mechanism to keep track of the page tables of the processes. So when there is a context switch, the dispatcher will find out the pointer to the page table from the process control block, and it will load the page table from the memory into the hardware tables if you are using, and from then that particular page table will be used. And how can this page table be implemented? One way to implement a page table is to have a set of registers. So you will have some hardware registers, and the details that are put into the page table will be put into these registers. For example, the DEC PDP-11 makes use of this kind of a page table, where they add the page table contents into hardware registers. This is helpful because here in this case you have very few number of entries. Why? Say you have 16 bit addresses that have been used for this particular architecture, and the page size is 8 kilobyte. 8 kilobyte is 2 power 3 is 8 into 2 power 10, that is 2 power 13 is the page size. And because 2 power 13 is the page size, 13 bits is used for the offset. The remaining 3 bits of the address is used for the page number. So since you have 3 bits for the page number, that can address 2 power 3 locations, which means that you can have 2 power 3, that is equal to 8 entries in the page table. So it is possible to have 8 entries in the page table, and hence you need 8 registers to have the page table. So it is enough to have just 8 registers, and hence the entries in the page table are just maintained in the registers in this kind of architecture. But this is not possible when you have the page table to be very large. When the page table becomes very large, when you have many number of entries, you cannot have so many number of registers. So in that case, what is done? The page table is kept in the main memory, and you have a register which will just remember the starting address of where the page table is kept in main memory. and that register is called a page table base register. So the page table base register has got the address which points to the starting location of the page table. And what can be done by the dispatcher in terms of context switch is that it need not actually change anything in the main memory or anything like that. It will just change what goes into the page table base register. So, if it is process P1 that is currently executing, then it will have the starting address of the page table of process P1 in the PTBR. Then when P2 has to execute, then it will just change the starting address in the PTBR as that of the starting address of the page table of process P2. So, the change that needs to be done by the dispatcher is only to change the values of this particular register. There is also another register that is maintained, which is called the page table length register. This has got the information about the size of the page table. So, if you have the size of the page table and the starting address of the page table, then any address can be checked with this length, as well as you can make use of the base address to access the actual location. And in this scheme, what happens is that you need to access the memory twice. Why twice? Once is to access the main memory to access the contents of the page table, and from there you get the frame number, and then from there the second time you add it with the offset to get the exact location of the physical memory where the actual content is available, and second time you access to get the actual content. So, you access the memory twice, once to get the page table and the second time to get the actual content which can either be the data or the instruction. So, here you see that the memory access is slowed down by a factor of 2. So, this 2 memory access problem, they have tried to solve it by making use of a hardware cache, a fast lookup hardware cache, which is called the associative memory or translation look aside buffers. So, in this what is done is that they maintain a cache where they have 2 parts, each entry has got 2 parts, a key and a value. And when an item is presented, that is compared simultaneously with all the keys that are present in the hardware cache. If there is a match, then the corresponding value is taken. So, how is this used in the case of pages and frames? You have the translation look aside buffer, which has got entries for pages and the corresponding frames. So, whenever there is a search that needs to be done here, the search is done in parallel. So, any page number that is generated is checked simultaneously with all the entries that are present here. Then, if you get a match, then the corresponding frame is taken out. If there is no match in this, then you need to look into the main memory to get the corresponding entry in the page table. So, look at this diagram where a translation look aside buffer is also added along with the usual mapping mechanism that we have got. So, what we learnt earlier is that the logical address is divided into a page number and an offset. The page number will be used as an index into the page table to get the frame number, to which you add the offset to get the physical location. But now, before it is checked with the page table, simultaneously you do a comparison or check with the TLB. So, at the same time it checks with all the entries in the TLB to check if there is a match with the page number that has been generated in the logical address. If there is a match in the page number, then you get the corresponding frame number and it is a TLB hit, that is you get the page number from the TLB itself. And then the frame number is added with the offset to get the physical address. In case it is a TLB miss, that is you are not able to find the page number that you are looking for in the TLB, then you use the page number as an offset into the page table. This page table can be present in the main memory. You try to access that and then try to get the exact frame number to which you add the offset. So, if there is a TLB miss, then what is done is that you go check in the page table which is in the main memory, and now whatever you have found out from the main memory, you now update it into the TLB also, so that the next time you will find the next reference in the TLB itself, you may get a hit next time. And now say you are trying to bring this page number and the frame number combination into the TLB, and if you find that the TLB is already full, then you need to select one entry in the TLB, remove that off, and then bring in this so that it can be useful the next time. But how, which one do you select to remove, or which will be the victim to be removed? You can have a lot of replacement policies, like you can have something like a least recently used. You can have some entry which remembers which TLB entry was used recently. If there was one which was not used recently, maybe that is an old memory reference, so you may not use it in the near future. So that is taken or chosen, and the needed one is brought inside. And because of having this TLB, the effective memory access time is improved, or the access time is reduced. How does it get reduced? We will see. Suppose if it takes epsilon time units to look into the associative lookup or to get some information from the TLB, and the memory cycle time is 1 microsecond, that is it takes 1 microsecond to access the physical memory. And then we have something called a hit ratio. We can calculate a hit ratio, that is the percentage of times a page number is found in the TLB or in the associative registers, and take this hit ratio as alpha. So how do we calculate the effective access time? That is calculated as 1 plus epsilon into alpha plus 2 plus epsilon into 1 minus alpha. That is, alpha is a hit ratio. So much percentage, for so much percentage, the effective, the access time is 1 plus epsilon. What is 1 plus epsilon? 1 is to look into the main memory, and epsilon is to look into the TLB. So when you look into the TLB, you get the frame number, and then use the frame number to get the actual memory content, which will take 1 microsecond. So totally it takes 1 plus epsilon time units, and that is alpha number of times or alpha percentage of times. And for the remaining 1 minus alpha times, you do not get a hit, it is a miss. If it is a miss, you once look into the TLB, that will take epsilon time units to find out whether it is present, it is not present. So you need to look into the physical memory once to get the page table, that will take 1 microsecond. And then from there you get the frame number, and again look into the physical memory to get the exact memory location, which will take another 1 microsecond. So it takes 2 plus epsilon time units, and that happens 1 minus alpha times. So this is how you calculate the effective access time. You can see an example of how this effective access time is calculated. Say it takes 20 nanoseconds to search the TLB, that is epsilon that we have seen now, and 100 nanoseconds to access the main memory. Earlier we have taken it as 1 microsecond. Now if the page number is present in the TLB, then the memory access time will be 120 nanoseconds. Why? 20 nanoseconds to search the TLB, and you will get the exact frame number, and then 100 nanoseconds to access the main memory to get the actual data or the instruction. And if it is a miss, if the page number is not present in the TLB, then it takes 220 nanoseconds. Why does it take 220? Because 120 nanoseconds to search the TLB, and it is a miss. So you need another memory access to search in the page table that is present in the main memory. That will take 100 nanoseconds. And then again you get the frame number from that page table, and then you need to check the memory again for another 100 nanoseconds to get the actual data or the instruction. So totally it takes 20 plus 100 plus 100, so that is 220 nanoseconds. So if the hit ratio is 80%, then 80% of the time you have 120 nanoseconds as the access time, and the remaining 20% of the time you have 220 nanoseconds as the access time. And hence the effective memory access time will be 0.8 into 120 plus 0.2 into 220, that is 140 nanoseconds. So we have seen how each is beneficial by having a translation leukocyte buffer. So the ways in which you can have the page tables are that you can have in hardware registers, or you can have them in the main memory, or you can have them in translation leukocyte buffer. Now we'll see how memory protection can be improved by using information that you add to the page table. So what can be done is that you can add some protection bit to the page table. So along with the page table entries corresponding to each page, you can have some protection bits, like you can say whether the page can be read only or read write or execute only. So whenever an address is generated, you also check if you are trying to write into that page or you are trying only to read from that page, and so on. If it is a page which is read only, or if you are trying to write into that page, then just trap is sent to the operating system and you say that the proper access is not done. Another bit that can be added to this page table entry is the valid invalid bit. This valid bit actually says that if that particular page is in the logical address space of the process, and if it is a legal page. If it is a page which is not present in the logical address space of the process, and if it is not a legal page, then the valid invalid bit is set. So if the invalid bit is set, and if an address is made, if a reference is made to that particular address, then in that case a trap is given to the operating system. Look at this example where you have a 14 bit address space, which means it can go from 0 to 16,383. To power 14, and the page size is 2 kilobytes, which means you can have, suppose, see what happens here. The logical address space goes from page 0 to page 5, you have 6 pages, and it occupies only say 10,468 byte is the size of this process. Even though the address space is a 14 bit address space, the size that is occupied by this process is only 10,468, which means it needs only 6 pages. And now if you look into the page table, you have entries for 6 pages as valid. The remaining 2 entries are kept as invalid. Even though the logical address space says that you can have 7 pages, the process has got only 6 pages, and hence they are marked as valid, and the remaining ones are marked as invalid. So whenever an address is generated which is above this 12,287, then that will be looked at as an invalid reference, and a trap will be given to the operating system. Here you can see that the size of the process is only 10,468, but still you can make references till 12,287. Above that it is not allowed, because this 12,287, till that it goes into this page, and part of this page is occupied by that process. So likewise, you can have a valid invalid bit which will decide on whether a particular page reference or memory reference is valid or not. And now we look at the different ways in which page tables can be structured. One is you can have hashed page tables, the next is you can have inverted page tables. It is also possible to have hierarchical page tables. We will see this one after the other. In hashed page tables, this is common when the address space is greater than 32 bits. Basically, when do you go for hashing to make the search easier? So here, when the address space goes greater than 32 bits, the number of entries in the page table can go very high. Then in that case, what is done is a hash value is used to hash into the page table. The page table will contain a chain of elements which hash to the same location, and each element will have 3 fields. One is the page number, the next is the matched page frame, and the next is the pointer to the next element in the linked list. And the virtual page numbers are compared in this chain while you are searching for a match. If there is a match, then the corresponding physical frame is extracted. Just look at this diagram, this example, where you use a hashed page table. The logical address, as we have seen earlier, is divided into a page number and an offset, and the page number is actually used as the virtual page number is used as a hash function, which is used to check into the hash table. Then it will have map on to one particular location where you have a chain of elements, and this chain of elements is actually you will have a virtual page number and a corresponding frame number. So, Q is the frame page number and S will be the frame number, and you also have a pointer that is pointing to the next element in this chain. And you check each of these elements and you find that there is a match here with P, and R is the corresponding frame number, the R is taken and is added with the offset to get the corresponding physical location. So, thus hashing can be used, a hash page table can be used when the number of entries becomes much larger and to make the searching easier. Next, another way in which you can maintain a page table is used to have an inverted page table. In the examples that we had seen earlier, we saw that each process has got its own page table. So, usually it is like that, where each process has got a page table associated with it. And the page table will have an entry for each page of that process. But now again, the problem here is that when the page table has got many number of entries or when the number of pages is very large, then in that case the page table size also becomes very large, and this page table will occupy a lot of space in the physical memory. It will consume large amount of space in the physical memory. So, the solution here is to go for something called an inverted page table. So, what is done in an inverted page table? Here you have only one page table. For all the processes all put together, there is only one page table. So, corresponding to each physical frame in the physical memory, you have an entry in the page table. So, if there are 32 physical frames, then you have 32 entries in the page table. And what you remember in each of the entry, you remember that in which in this physical frame, the page of which process is kept, that information is stored in this page table. So, each entry has the virtual address of the page that is stored in the actual location and the information about the process that is owning that particular page. So, you will have only one page in the system, page table in the system, and you do not have to have a number of page tables, it is enough to have just one page table. So, just look at this diagram. Here you see that the CPU generates a logical address which has got a page number and an offset. Now, you combine this page number and the process ID of the process, and that is searched in this page table. So, you search for the process ID, and if there is a matching, then you also check if the page number is matching. So, when this process ID and page number combination is matching, then you get this frame number, and that is added with the offset to get the physical memory. So, this decreases the memory needed to store each page table, but the problem here will be that it will increase the search time. In the earlier case, when we had individual page tables for each process, we just used the page number as an index into the page table to get the corresponding frame. But here you can't do like that, you will have to search each entry one after the other to look for a combination of this process ID and the page number. And only then, suppose if it is the last entry, you will have to go through the entire page table to get the corresponding memory reference. So, using a hash table, what you can do is you can limit the search that has been done, you can search limit the search having hashing along with an inverted page table. So, summary for today's class, we learnt about how page table can be maintained, where page table can be kept. Page tables can be kept in registers, can be kept in the main memory, or it can be kept in translation look aside buffers. But when the size of the page table is very small, you can keep them in registers because you will have only limited number of registers. But if you have a larger page table size, then you can keep them in the main memory. But keeping in main memory will increase the search time because you will have to look into the main memory twice, once to search the page table and the next time to find out the exact location where the data or the instruction is present. So to reduce the time taken to search, this double search time, what is done is you maintain a hardware cache where you maintain a few number of page numbers and the frame numbers, which is called a translation lookaside buffer. So I look into the TLB to find out if there is a hit. If the page number is present, then you take it from the TLB itself and reduce the searching or looking into the main memory. If there is a miss, then you will have to look into the main the page table that is present in the main memory and bring in the required contents into the TLB for future reference. And then we saw that we can have different kind of page table structures. One is to have a hashed page table. In a hashed page table, what is done? You have more number of entries. When the number of entries becomes very large, searching the page table is made easier by having a hash value. And then it's also possible to have an inverted page table where you have a single page table rather than having individual page tables for each process. Have a single page table and each location in the page table corresponds to a physical frame, and you may remember in the page table page number of which process is kept in that particular physical memory location. And here again the problem will be that you need to search through the page table one after the other to get the exact memory location. So the references are acknowledgement. Thank you.